What is up, guys? And of course, as always, welcome back to another, of course, LBA Wi-Fi battle. And of course, this being the season 7 and week 2. And we're going up against Ash Nakai or Eric. And his team is a very tough one. I definitely was debating how to tackle this team. I was in the middle of changing mons. I definitely gave up on Zilavalli and Fretress for Magneton and Corbelion. And of course, I actually dropped Magneton for Rotom Wash in the next coming week. So I'm starting to feel comfortable with my team. But versus Eric, he did have a few shakes here that did make it tough for me of just using Rain as a whole. That said, I'm still using Rain. Like, you know, it's still going down, most certainly so. So his team is as following here: Mega Blastoise, Celestia, Jolteon, Decidueye, Dugtrio, and Deoxys Defense. And Deoxys Defense primarily is one of those Pokemon that you don't face it too often. It's definitely a Pokemon that can occur in leagues, but outside of that, it is an uber Pokemon. With good intentions, so it's a very good lead, Selfrog's very good with recover and whatnot. Very tough to tackle, though my offensive Pokemon's gonna definitely take it on and to it, KO it. So I'm not too scared of it, but I'm kind of feeling it's a possible lead. My complete set of Pokemon here is a Jolly, Swampert, able to outspeed at plus 2 Autonomize, Zilisla, and outside of that Waterfall, we have, I do believe, Ice Punch, Selfrog, and I do believe Earthquake, so pretty solid and standard Swampert here. Pelipper here is also kind of standard. We have Hurricane, we have Scald, I do believe a Roost, and then the filler move is Defog, in case of the Deoxys Defense just setting up versus me. Magneton is a Scarfed variant with Flash Cannon, Volt Switch, Hidden Power, I do believe Ground, if I remember correctly. Weird filler, actually. And I do believe Thunderbolt, something like that. Kind of weird set, but I didn't need anything like that. It has Magnet Pulse to be able to lock in Celestia, though I need to watch out for, of course, the Shed Skin, or the Shed Shell item that can manage to actually switch out versus me. The Celestia can definitely do that. Kabutops, Adamant set with Rock UMC. Should be able to deal with any matchups here fairly well. The only thing it doesn't outspeed is a Quick Feet Jolteon. That's the only thing you need to worry about. It should be said here that this set was supposed to have Sword Stance, have Rapid Spin over that, and it was a mistake, but it didn't matter in the whole scheme of things, considering what Kabutops brought to the table. This specific Wi-Fi bell, it actually might not have been that bad. Then we have Corbelion with Dual Dance in Sword Stance, Rock Polish, Iron Head, and Close Combat, and standard Gengar with Life Orb, and yeah, just do its usual thing, really. And from the get-go here, since we see that his possible only Defogger could be his Decidueye, I'm gonna bank on that to be, well, his only response to that. So with that in mind, I'm gonna lead off with Swampert, and just as fast as possible get my rocks up so the Dugtrio gets his sash broken if it switch in. So with all this in mind, let's go into the match. So, like I said, from the get-go, I lead off with my Mega Swampert, as he leads off with his Mega Blastoise. And it's not necessarily such a bad thing, but the one thing is to be considered here. He does actually evolve before me. I have actually fully speed, basically. There is really nothing here to manage the Blastoise. I was surprised he was faster than me, which tells me it's probably a more offensive Blastoise. Which is actually a good thing, because that means that Rock UMC Kabutops can actually one-hit KO this Pokemon. So with that in mind, he's gonna go for the Scald. Luckily, I don't get burned here, which I do believe is really, really good. And I definitely don't expect this thing to have Rapid Spin since it is offensive. So the rocks are probably here to stay, as I suspect him to go for another Scald, as I'm gonna switch into my into my Magneton, as he actually brings in his Decidueye here. Now, I don't fear Decidueye. This environment, I do feel fine, as he will stay in here. We do outspeed him, and the Flash Cannon does a really good chunk of damage, as he go for Spirit Shackle, and this does a lot of damage, which tells me this is an offensive Decidueye, and he can free switch here since I am locked in, and Celestia seems to be the obvious switch in here. And since he switched out, I kind of felt that probably Scarfed, actually, the more I think about it. And I am fully speed, so I would potentially speed time with that Pokemon. As Celestia commands, it does take a good chunk of damage, but this is definitely a dangerous environment, primarily because of the things it can bring to the table. So I'm gonna send in Quack, as all I really hope is for an Earthquake to be able to KO, as we are gonna see Giga Drain, and Giga Drain does a fair amount of damage, I won't deny that, you know, a fully defensive, not special defense, so it just does damage. As I'll freely here go for a skull, I'm basically baiting for a possible burn, and what do you know? Smack, we pull that off as we see Leech Seed. So now I'm feeling this possibly is a defensive variant, and really not a whole lot I can do from here. I don't believe he would go possibly for another, what do you call it? Another Gatorade from here, though it is a possibility. So with that in mind, I'm gonna pull a bit of a double here and go to my Azazel. I predicted the Gatorade to be able to soak that as well as possible. And then from this turn, I'm actually going to switch out my Kabutops, predicting either the Earthquake or possibly the, the Heavy Slam. As we get the Curse Body, which means that Kabutops can come in even more freely. I don't need to worry about Gatorade to, of course, KOing the Kabutops, and Kenshiro comes in as we see the Heavy Slam, and that's pretty darn alright. As sadly, here is where I realize I don't have Sword Stance, so I can't set up towards it. And it would have been a tremendous opening by default, but it's quite alright. Since it bringing actually the Deoxys' defense, now I'll go directly for the Waterfall. And as you guys will see, we will get a tremendous heavy hit here. It actually showcased here that this was a crit. But it should definitely be stated that since I am adamant, this is no matter what a 2-hit KO. So it wouldn't have mattered with rocks in mind, but that sure as hell helped. As now I get a big opening for something else, as I still outspeed everything on his team. As he brings in the Blastoise, and I said before, after rocks here, Continental Crush should definitely be a KO here. So I'm gonna go directly for it. We're gonna showcase what we are all about and what Kabutops is all about, which is a beast monster and just destroyer of the worlds, really. As he gonna send off the world that is his own, the Continental Crush. And we actually find out here that he's not fully offensive. He has some HP investment, actually 60. So the roll here to me to KO him was 80%, not 102 as I persevered. So we get a bit of bad roll there, but doesn't matter. We get the heavy amount of damage towards the Blastoise, and we are able to keep going with the pressure and, of course, KOing the poor, poor Blastoise, showcasing which one is the superior Water Starter. As he's gonna send in Thunderstruck to Jolteon. Now, I was really hoping, and I pray to God, I was really hoping that this Jolteon wasn't Quick Feet going in, because I knew I was right there and then in a tough position. As it goes for Hidden Power, gonna show me Hidden Power Grass, which is both good and bad. The bad part being that since I'm not a Violine that got prior damage onto me, this Shadow Ball actually could kill, and it will. And it's unfortunate, but at the same time, you know, I wouldn't have hurt him a quite a lot. Hidden Power Ground would have done roughly 50%. As I bring in Firethorn, hoping I can actually force him out, as I'm actually predicting him here to go for a Volt Switch, as I'm gonna send in Quack. And basically, all I'm really gonna do with this in mind is go for Broke, really, and bring my Swampert back again. Because I like Swampert, I do believe Swampert is a tremendous good Pokemon, and it can definitely provide itself a really good amount of damage. As with this in mind, he's gonna bring in Diggit, and we break the Sash, which I was hoping it had. Find out later it actually was a Fly MC variant for Buzzwole, which I didn't bring. As I can easily here go for, of course, a Waterfall. His switch in here is just actually kill the Sylvana, and it's a very, very fair switch in. He really can't do anything while he's burned. And Waterfall will just annihilate the Zilisla. So Swampert yet again coming back and just annihilating anything in his path. As Thunderstruck yet again comes in. And at this point on, you know, he's gonna go for Hidden Power Grass. My best play here is to go to Gengar and probably sack it. And then try to go for Rock Polish with my Kabutops. As he goes for Hidden Power Grass, and this works, of course. As we get yet again Curse Body activated. You know, it's tremendous how well Curse Body has worked this game. And now I get a free switch into my Mega Swampert, since he can't hurt me with Thunderbolt. The only move that he does have that can hurt me is Shadow Ball. And Shadow Ball do not hurt me that much. As, Shadow Ball is a thing. And it does a fair amount of damage. I mean, that's roughly, I do believe, 40. But as you guys know, Swampert is back, and Swampert's gonna kill something yet again. This time, it is the Dugtrio, which is the Offering of Souls. As we're gonna, of course, take him down. So, smack. That's no more Dugtrio for you. So Swampert clearly showcasing what it's all about, but we can't outspeed the Thunderstruck. Jolteon keeps coming at it. And from this point on, you know, I felt, you know, I only have so many switch-ins left. I might as well sack Swampert here and bank on my Kabutops to pull this off in the end. Now, this is definitely something that should be stated here, that the ideal play here for me was not to do what I did here. He will actually go for a Volt Switch. I forgot about Volt Switch for a few seconds. I should definitely gone for Rock Polish, because Decidueye is dealing a good amount of health. But the reason this is such a good thing is because I do get a lot of damage on my Kobelion, which puts me in an area where he can't KO me with anything, not even Braebird, from this range. And what I'm trying to say here is that I actually kind of choked the game away, because at this point I can't outspeed him. I really can't. So Jolteon will come in back again, and this time I have no way of actually taking any prior damage onto it. I actually kept Kobelion healthy for a really long time here, but I do fail to go for my opportunity of setting up. Now, we did debate this afterward, and quite honestly, I do believe my best play here versus Jolteon would be bringing in actually my, because Curse Spot activates again, because that's a thing. Smack. Wonderful. But yeah, me and Eric talked about it later, that it, you know, it was a 50-50 whether or not it would have gone for Thunderbolt, but I knew that Eric would have lost had he gone for Thunderbolt there, and she definitely kept that in mind and sacked actually my my Gengar instead of staying in. Because had I done that, you know, I would definitely have lost my Gengar towards his Decidueye. Volt Switch would not have KO'd Gengar from that range. I believe at least it was a roll. But no, most certainly I would have survived it. But then again, Decidueye would have outspeeded. Most likely would have locked himself into Braebird or Spirit Shackle. None of those moves would have been a triad KO on Kobelion. Kobelion can easily set up Rock Polish twice and outspeed Jolteon the following turn. Of course, annihilating Decidueye. The same thing going versus, I do believe, the Jolteon. Now, it should be said that had he gone for Thunderbolt, I would have been a 2-hit KO, and a Rock Polish would not have been enough to outspeed a Jolteon. But as I stated, the ideal play for Eric to actually win this match was not lose any more damage towards Jolteon, and go for the Volt Switch, get the residual damage towards my Kobelion was the ideal play. I failed to see that at the time, and once I saw it, I was like facepalming, because I realized I kind of choked. I mean, it was a 50-50, but the ideal play for Eric was to do that series of play, and I should definitely have seen that one coming. And I was really, really, afterwards, feeling kind of dumb. That said, though, this game was tremendous. He was playing offensively here really, really well, and I actually appreciated that, because they made a momentum shift all the time. Though, as stated here, losing my Capitas fairly early, yeah, it was unfortunate. I definitely believe that I would have been in a stronger position had I let the Blastoise live and let the rain come back. That probably would have been better, actually, now to think about it, than, or, you know, straight off KOing it at that point. Because Capitas was really, really important for this game. Losing it early, yeah, it was kind of bad. It was actually fairly bad. Same thing with Magneton. Shadow Ball would not have been that scary towards me, so I do believe I sacked the wrong Pokemon as a whole. But at the same time, I do pressure Eric quite well, and it actually turned out to be just a 1-0 loss, and I'm actually fairly glad by that. I do believe I had the way to turn this game around, and I failed to do so in the end, making Eric the very well-worthy winner here, because I should definitely have seen his last play going on. I missed that, and I would definitely say that I choked the game away due to it. That said, though, as I said, I did enjoy this match. I thought it was a tremendous battle between us. So Eric, as always, thank you so much for this battle. And for everybody who's been watching, I hope you enjoyed this game as much as I did. And if you didn't, well, too bad for you. Huh. So anyway, guys, as always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care.